wall is attached to the throne, according to Ibn Kathir. The womb is attached to the throne, who is powerful enough to bring the garment of Allah down.
You know, this sister has literal meaning and is metaphoric meaning.
Okay, what is
did
the...
You study, did you study?
Give me both, both meaning. Give me the both meaning.
I don't know because I haven't studied it.
Allah fucks Christian. Does that Allah fit the dog as well, sir?
So God died.
Tell me Matthew 27. Then Allah stepped into the world to speak to Moses, who was running the universe. Nah, shin of Allah.
Okay, you are
I believe in the Sunnah. Yes.
Okay. Sunni. Okay. What is it about? What is it about Islam make you to be Muslim? Why are you Muslim?
What makes you become a Christian?
Because I came to the conclusion that Islam is false religion, Muhammad is false prophet, and I have seen what Lord Jesus Christ did for me, how he poured his love, how he's poured his love on me. You are not even allowing me to finish. So
yeah,
is that not your intention?
So, that's just your
and I did have no any other option to not turn to him. So now, what is your reason that you are Muslim?
Because I believe you believe in one God and that is Allah and Prophet Muhammad SAW is a messenger.
So what is it about one God you believe and what is it about Muhammad that you believe he is the messenger?
Like Christians, I don't believe in three gods. There's a lot of
I'm Christian. I don't believe in three gods. So can you make your Trinity? Can you make your case first?
Do you believe in
I
Trinity?
Believe in Trinity. Trinity is
so
not
Trinity
three gods.
Means three gods.
No,
isn't it?
No, sir. That shows your lack of knowledge as well as lack of knowledge of Allah. So give me your reason. What is
Jesus
do you mean?
Jesus is a
give me your reason. I don't say that. I don't say that. I don't say God is three. So can you give me your reason? What do you mean when you say you believe in one God?
What do I believe? There's only one God.
Okay. What kind of God is this God? Huh? What kind of God is this God?
What kind of God? He's almighty. He's all seeing. He's not like any. He's not like a human
what
body.
What does he look like? He,
a God cannot be born. A God does not eat. A God does not. A God does not need to be taken care of the way Jesus was taken care of, and you say he is God.
Okay.
So I
find that's very interesting that all you told me about what are the things your God cannot do, I find that's very sad. And I am so sorry that you don't know. I am, sir, can you be kind enough and then let me speak as well?
No.
Okay? So let me just bring up a couple of things which you expressed that Allah doesn't have body parts. I would love you to be kind enough and then tell me about the body parts of Allah.
Body parts?
He has a shin.
Shin?
Body parts?
And two right hands. He doesn't have left arm.
No, two right arms.
Two
right arms.
Two right arms.
He's two eyes, not like... not like Satan. Allah has two eyes.
You're talking about Jesus.
And the Muslim can recognize Allah's shin.
After this, you wish we are talking about Jesus. Just get on the line. You will wish we are talking about Lord Jesus because Allah is going to humiliate you now.
Yes, Hatun.
It's Hatun, but that's fine.
Hatun.
It's Hatun, but that's
Hatun.
Fine, sir. Okay, Surah 68 verse 42.
Yeah.
Open it for me.
Go ahead.
Surah 68.
I'm listening.
Oh, as a Muslim, you don't even have the Quran with you.
I have the Quran.
Okay. Surah 68 verse 42. Surah 68 verse 42.
Sure,
you don't have it. Good. Great, great. So, I'm asking what is this is talking about, okay? The day that the shin shall be laid bare and they shall be sung to the prostrate. But they shall not be able to. I already told you Surah 68 verse 42.
I have a book.
Surah 68 verse 42.
Verse 62. Read it in Arabic for me. Who translated this? Can you tell me the reference? Who translated the Quran?
Is that the level you have?
No, tell
so
me.
So you came to confront me. The level you have is this. Okay? I don't have my Quran with you. All I am is I am depend on you to produce
the
Quranic verse. Which I did. Now, you don't like
the,
my translation.
Question.
Pick it up. Pick it up your Quran.
I'm asking,
go to the Sheikh Google. Go to the Sheikh Google, Surah 68, verse 42.
That's maybe that's where you're getting your nonsense from.
Surah 68, verse 42.
Where, who translated this? Where, which website?
Okay, let me read it in deeper for everyone. Surah 68 is not which book, that is the Quran, holy book of Muslims, the one which has holes in it. The one is going to become a pale man and intercede for you on the day of judgment. That book, okay, Surah 68 verse 42. I'm not talking about Surah Bible, I'm talking about the shin of Allah. I want to know, is the shin of Allah is shaved? I want to know, is the shin of Allah is white or black? I want to know, if Allah has only one shin, how you are going to recognize that?
You call yourself a Christian, sir, but then you come here, you're debating about Islam. You want me
look
to
at,
call, you
look
want
at my
to
beautiful
in
face.
Jesus, yeah?
Look at my beautiful face without the glasses.
Wow,
okay?
I don't think so.
I don't fall into that.
I don't think
you
so.
You expressed you are Muslim. You expressed you believe in one God. I asked you about the qualities
now,
of your God. You failed to tell me that your God is a deceiver. You failed to tell me that your God prays. Now, therefore, I am asking about the shin of Allah.
And your group, that's why I call them clowns. You come here, you just talk shit
about
Islam.
About the shin of
you talk
Allah.
Nonsense about Islam. You
got to subject
about
the
shin of Allah. Tell me about the shin of
bring
Allah.
Verses out the air. You bring all the verses out.
About the shin of Allah.
Surah 68, verse 42.
She read from the Quran, and you are telling her. She read from the Quran, and inside she talked about the Quran. That says what the Quran is full of.
21st century, yes, Muslims are using that. I cannot pronounce that word, but that word for the Quran.
Is Quran or not?
Can I have a look?
Yeah.
You see, why are you so scared?
Oh, why I'm scared?
Brother, from my experiences, I'll tell you, two times Muslims stole my Quran. Last week they did the third attempt to steal my Quran again.
What's the verse, Hattie?
Surah 68, verse 42. I already told more than three times. Look, we are processing now, progressing.
Yep.
Read it for us.
Surah 62.
Surah 68, verse 42.
Surah 68, sorry. 68,
yep,
42.
The day the shin will be uncovered, yep, and they are invited to prostrate, and they, the disbelievers, will not be able.
Okay, so tell them about this shin. Who is shin is this?
A shin is that, yeah? A shin is that. That's,
yeah,
a shin.
Yeah, but that's the English thing, though. That's the English shin. There's loads of a clock.
Okay, so what is the shin? What is the shin in that verse?
See the Arabic word. So
okay,
open
the Arabic.
Maybe I'll find the Arabic.
Open Arabic. I am sure while shin is in English shin, in Arabic shin will be my mother or Allah. Maybe they meant Allah.
Yeah. You need to go to, as a Muslim, you need to recognize the shin of Allah.
That's
so very important.
Now, whatever you're talking about now, you want me to become a Christian, you believe in Christianity is the
right
thing.
I want you to make a case
are you
for
gonna,
Allah. No,
I don't need to make a case for Allah.
No, you express, this is the level.
You
don't touch
me
again.
Jesus.
Don't ever touch me again. So, here's the bottom line.
The one who came,
you know, they are so confident, they are so confident that why they are Muslim. The moment you ask them, okay, tell me about Allah,
me about
what did you hear?
Khatun.
Did you hear Allah is a deceiver? No, you didn't. Did you hear Allah prays? No, you didn't. Did you hear Allah's body parts being explained? He expressed that Allah doesn't have body parts. All I'm asking you to tell me about the shin of Allah. Please tell me about the shin of Allah. You believe in the Quran? This is your supreme authority. Tell me about the shin of Allah. No, I don't.
Do you want me to go to heaven? I don't. So what's your job here then?
So I want you to tell me about the shin of Allah.
See, this is why I call you a missionary. You come here, you talk nonsense about Islam and about the people.
If this is nonsense, why don't you expose me? Great opportunity to explain to us about the shin of Allah.
You want me to become Christian?
Sir,
so tell me.
Lord, it's not about what I want. It is Lord Jesus Christ, the one who died on the cross, and on the third day, who conquered the grave, wants you to turn to him and fall in love with him. All I am asking is to tell me about the shin of Allah.
Your God died on the cross.
Tell me about the shin of Allah.
Your God died on the cross.
Tell me about the shin of Allah.
Your God died on the cross.
Does this look like shin of Allah?
Does this look your God died. So who's running the world?
Tell me about the sin of Allah.
Your God died.
Tell me about the Surah 27. When Allah stepped into the world to speak to Moses, who was running the universe? Nah, sin of Allah. Tell me about the sin of Allah. Tell me about who is feeding the Allah. Tell me how Allah is jogging. Tell me how Allah becomes hungry. But before that, tell me about the sin of Allah. Tell me about the sin of Allah.
Your God got crucified.
Tell me about the sin of Allah. No, that's the level. You can't engage. When people live, they are praying in the freezer.
I never heard her talk about her own religion.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's my point.
All I am asking, Muslims to tell me about the sin of Allah. On the day of judgment, sin of Allah is going to be uncovered. It's going to be uncovered, and people are going to recognize Allah from his shin. Okay, yes, Muslim Express, Allah doesn't have a body part. So what is this shin? That's all I am asking. Islam is rubbish. You know Islam is rubbish. While Islam is rubbish, you are not expecting me to give Islam roses and baklava. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. Tell me about the holes in the narrative as well as the shin of Allah.
Teach your own religion.
Tell me about the shin of Allah. My ideology teaches me to destroy the false ideologies. I am here to do so right now. So tell me about the shin of Allah.
You know, I know people.
Tell me about the shin of Allah.
People that have become Muslim because of
you. Tell me about the shin of Allah. Tell me about the shin of Allah.
Because of what you preach. Become Christians because of it.
People have become Muslim.
Tell me about the shins of. Tell me about the shins of Allah. Are you trying to tell me? So there are people who become a Muslim because of me.
Four people here now.
And wow, did you pick that up? It's not Allah guided them, it is I guided them. According to Muslims, I am Allah. I can guide people. I can guide people. According to Christians, it is only Lord Jesus Christ. It is only Lord Jesus Christ. Now,
I want to
see
two people that have converted to Islam.
Shin of Allah. Shin of Allah.
Bring
tell
them.
Me about the shin of Allah. Tell me about the shin of Allah.
Please, will a Muslim expose her?
That's the shin of Allah.
Please. There must be a Muslim scholar that can expose her.
Come close. Come close.
Shin of Allah, come on, Muslim. Destroy her with
Quran. It's not I am saying Allah has a shin. Quran 68 verse 42 is telling Allah's shin is going to be uncovered. So therefore, I am trying to figure out what the shin of Allah look like. Because the way shin of Allah look like, people are going to recognize it. Have you practiced to figure out what the shin of Allah look like? Did he shave this?
Okay, we know that.
Does he use shaving cream? Did he wax it?
If you know it, respond to it.
Did Allah wax his shin? Did Allah shave his shin?
I need saving.
Is the shin of Allah? Is the shin of Allah white or black?
I need saving.
Comparing to mine? Compared to mine. Okay? I got leggings. I can't. But brother, can you see that blue trousers? You just a little bit.
You don't want to see that.
That's right.
When you see it, you will recognize it.
How? What is the shin of Allah is different from mine? I don't have hairs on my leg. Does Allah, shin of Allah, does the shin of Allah has hair? Does the shin of Allah has hair? It does matter. People need to figure out, is it same with my shin or is it same with someone? It will help you to recognize. And isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing?
I've never heard you preach your own religion. Never. What do you come to the park for? I've never heard you preach
your own religion. What do you come to the park for?
Tell me about the shin of Allah. Tell me about the shin of Allah. I cannot convert anyone. Lord Jesus Christ does so. Lord Jesus Christ does his part. Tell me about the holes in the narratives. Actually, sorry, shins of Allah. Tell me about the shin of Allah. Tell me about the shin of Allah.
I need saving.
What does Shin of Allah look like?
I need saving.
What does Shin of Allah look like?
I don't have the knowledge to teach. When you don't have knowledge, you be quiet. Well, not this old
man. You should teach him. What does the Shin of Allah look like?
Calm down.
What does the Shin of Allah look like?
See, you speak with knowledge or you sound like
a teacher. Teach us about the Shin of Allah.
Save us.
Teach us about the Shin of Allah.
Tell us about your
Lord
religion.
Jesus Christ takes you to heaven.
Lord Jesus Christ gives himself for you.
Tell me about the Shin of Allah.
Tell us about your religion. Tell me about the Shin of Allah.
Converters. Tell me about the Shin of Allah.
Converters. What's your religion?
Tell me about the Shin of Allah.
Are you a Muslim?
Tell me about the Shin of Allah. Tell me about the Shin of Allah. You didn't listen. Listen. I cannot save anyone. I cannot convert anyone. It is the work of God. It is. God wants you to turn to Him. God wants you to repent. Therefore, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, gave Himself on the cross for you. So you turn to Him and you have Him. I take you to hell. I cannot save you. God saves you. Now, tell me about the shins.
She told you the gospel. Now tell her about the Shin of Allah.
Shin of Allah.
Teacher, yes, the question.
Shin of Allah.
I came here earlier. She was talking to somebody.
It's going to be uncovered. Yeah?
Yes. Is it hairy? Does Allah use shaving cream? Does Allah wax his shin?
If Allah has that word,
then absent, dead.
That bird will find out Allah has a hairy chin or not.
That's not good at all. Too late.
The whole hood will tell us.
Surah 68 verse 42 identifies little bit body parts of Allah. I haven't even talked about the womb of Allah. Allah has a womb which makes Allah scream out. I haven't even touched that.
Jesus was in his mother's womb.
That they believe one God Jesus and that God doesn't have the body parts. Yet, so far, I am the Shin of Allah. I can show you the womb of Allah.
Stop talking about Allah. Talk about Christianity. Save me.
I want
to be saved.
I want someone to
save me.
Save me!
Talk
ask
about Jesus!
Jesus
is God! Yeah. He died! Jesus. Your God died!
Tell me about the Shin of Allah! I am not Muhammad.
Respect the other religion. Don't do
why?
That.
Why Islam doesn't respect me? Islam doesn't respect me, and you want me to respect Islam? Who do you think you are? You are someone who needs to repent and turn to Lord Jesus Christ. You can abuse all that language. You can use all that language. Feel free to do so. See, go to the Mr. Police. Turn to the camera. See. Muslim is crying to Mr. Police. Oh, Mr. Police, someone is asking us question for Surah 68 verse 42. We don't know how to answer. We don't know how to answer. Mr. Policeman, please help us. Please help us. That's what's happening.
Says why Allah having a shin is a problem for Islam.
Muslims just told us that Allah doesn't have a body part. So that's first problem. Second problem is, where is the second shin? And then you've got lots of problems.
So they have, okay.
Come on, Muslim.
What's the problem?
Are you Muslim?
No.
Okay.
You didn't even know.
You are Muslim. You are a Christian.
Tell me about the Shin of Allah.
That's all you know.
Tell me about the Shin of Allah. Do you want to talk about the womb of Allah? That's the Shin of Allah.
Talk to me about Jesus. You're a Christian.
Tell me about Jesus, who is much faster creator than Allah. Tell me about Jesus, who creates the bird with his breath and then gives life to the bird. Versus it takes whole day for Allah to create Adam. Even Islamic Jesus is much powerful than Allah. If you want to talk about Jesus, I am happy to talk about Jesus. But you've got to know how to answer the question.
Satan.
Allah?
Yeah, Satan.
Allah, look, they are calling Allah Satan. Probably they just read Surah 72. You do have Quran, which so-called the word of Allah, contains the verse of Satan in one point, and Muhammad bowed down and worshipped those pagan gods. Surah 53 verse 19, Surah 22 verse 52. So attacking other religions makes me feel Allah fucks Christians. Does that Allah fit the dog as well, sir, according to your criteria? If attacking the ideology makes someone filthy dog, Muhammad and Allah and Quran does that, is it the same criteria for Allah and Muhammad? Tell me about the Shin of Allah. Tell me about the Shin of Allah. Come on, man. You can do it.
Allah Shin.
You can do it. Tell me about the Shin of Allah. Or you can tell me about the womb of Allah. Do you want to tell me about the womb of Allah? How come Allah has a womb which causes pain to Allah? That's all I'm asking. You express Muslims that Allah doesn't have a body part. Yet, I'll give you list after list where we will get to hear the body parts of Allah. Trying things on me is not going to shut me up. You should have learned that before though. So, body parts of Allah. Body parts of Allah. Allah has a shin. Allah has a waist. Allah has a foot. Allah even has a shade. Allah speaks behind the veils. That's where Muslims learn from. Allah appears as a young man. Listen what Allah looks like. Listen what Allah looks like.
Allah has two rights.
No, I'm going to talk about how Allah looks like exactly, man. So this is what Allah looks like. The Prophet saw Allah before his death, as the doctrine of majority blah 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 states.
No, she's the throwing Allah.
I saw my Lord in a form of curly hair, breathless young man wearing green robe. I saw Allah with curly hair. Beard. Allah doesn't have a beard and wearing a green robe. Mr. Muslim,
green robe.
Wow. Allah doesn't have a beard.
Look here.
He's young.
Allah?
Allah. No.
Are you Allah?
He doesn't have a curly hair.
No, he doesn't have curly hair.
Allah has a curly hair. Beardless young man who is wearing a green robe. Muslims.
So maybe Muhammad saw Allah in a young age.
I don't know. Maybe Allah is just growing up. I don't know. Like. Certain things are happening there, which doesn't look very good at all. It's not only Mr. Muslims, Mr. Policeman, please help us. Mr. Policeman, please help us. She read from our sources that Allah has a curly hair.
Yeah. Oh, curly hair. Wow.
She read from our sources, yeah. Allah is, what was it?
Beard.
Beardless. Allah is beardless. Does Allah do boxing?
Allah doesn't have beard. Yeah.
No beard.
Allah is wearing green robe.
So why Muslims are keeping beard when Allah has no beard?
Allah has no beard. Muslims are having beard.
That's a good question. Uncle.
Oh, Allah is not human. He says Allah is not human, but he doesn't have beard.
So Allah doesn't have a beard, but he's got mustache.
So he has two right hands.
According to source, as Muhammad says, I saw my Lord with curly hair, with a mustache, but not a beard, wearing green clothes.
Oh, it's a fake news.
Fake news?
Oh, Sahih Muslim.
Hadith Kitab El Asma, spots of Allah is the fake. Yeah. Okay? Tell me about the shape of Allah then. Does Allah have a shape? But, so Allah's shin is not human shin, it's different. What is the difference?
Are you telling me?
Why not? You are going to recognize him from his shin. You are going to recognize him from his shin.
Writers are false writers. Not all of them.
One or two of them.
Maybe one or two are false, all other are true. He says Sahih Bukhari is a false writer.
According to who?
According to him.
No, I didn't say Sahih.
This is what he said.
Is Muhammad liar?
No.
So Muhammad himself says, I saw my Lord.
Look at this.
Muhammad is speaking, okay? Your prophet, so-called walking Quran, who never speaks his own desire, is saying, I saw my Lord.
Yeah.
He's wearing green dress, green robe.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a beard, but he's got mustache. And he looks like a young man.
Yeah.
Muhammad, I'm sorry if Muhammad is a liar. If Muhammad is a liar, give Muhammad up. Muhammad is saying, this is not me again. Allah descends every night to the lowest heaven when one third of the first part of the night is over and says, I am the Lord. I am the Lord. Who is there to supplicate me so that I answer him? Who is there to beg me so that I can grant him? Who is there to beg forgiveness from me so that I can forgive them? Allah comes down because when Allah is on the seventh heaven, Allah's hearing is not very good. Allah needs to come to the third heaven to hear those people who are asking for forgiveness. See, even Allah, who is supposed to be the creator of the universe, is not able to hear what people are saying. Who is asking forgiveness? Allah comes down so that he can hear you. And Allah wants you to beg him. It is all problem. Let's talk about Allah's foot.
My God is coming back.
It will not be filled until Allah puts his foot over it.
Allah is going to put his foot in the fire. Muslim, tell us, Allah has a foot or Allah has a foot. Tell us.
What about Allah? I know, it is funny. All we can do is make fun of Allah. I know. Please continue to make fun of Allah. I am sure Allah is so proud of you as you make fun of him. When he sees you as you end up in hell, when he puts his feet, he will remember that guy is the one who was making fun of me.
I'll cut you 100 million times. You know, you die, they put you back in life. You die.
in your dreams, in your dreams, in your dreams. Tell me about the beds of Allah.
What?
Bed.
Bed, yeah. Allah has
Allah sleeping
on the sleeping on the couch.
Do you want to talk about?
He believes that Allah has body parts. He does actually believe in that.
Allah. You don't believe
Allah has
a hand. Allah has a shin?
Yeah, yes.
So, you believe Allah has a boom?
What?
Boom.
Womb? Why would I believe that? Which source is that? You mean like a woman?
You don't...
Are you? Woman, womb.
I don't understand that thing she says. What, a womb?
Womb, womb.
Yes, sir, yes.
Yeah.
Where's that source that actually says that?
The sources are a Muslim sources.
Thank you,
Matthew. It's a Muslim source.
So, just want to identify. Previously, Muslim man who was telling us Allah doesn't have body parts. Now we've got a Muslim who tells us that Allah has body parts, and we will dig into it. Let's see the body parts of Allah. Sahih Bukhari.
Sahih Bukhari.
7,502.
Yes.
Repeat the number, please.
7,502.
Messenger of Allah said, Allah created the creation, and when he finished from his creation, the womb got up and said to it, stop.
Womb
says to Allah, stop.
Womb says to Allah, stop.
Womb says to Allah, Sahih Bukhari, 7,502. Let me read it again. In case you missed it, it's very important.
Yes.
Even the womb of Allah is fighting with Allah. Allah created...
Sorry,
7,502. Allah created the creation, and when he finished from his creation, the womb got up and said, womb got up and said, stop, what do you want? It said, at this place I seek refuge with you and from all those who serve me. Allah said, would you be pleased that I will keep good relations with those who I want. See? Womb got up, told Allah off, and then Allah is making bridges here. Ibn Kathir? Ibn Kathir? Ibn Kathir? So this is Ibn Kathir? So, first one I read. So I get two sources.
So Allah has three daughters also. Okay.
So I gave you two sources. Sahih Bukhari, 7,502.
You couldn't find that one.
I'm sorry, you couldn't find it. No worries. I am so good person.
Are you providing the sources from Islamic sources? Oh, Christian. It's not Christian. Sahih Bukhari is not a Christian. Sahih Muslim is not a Christian.
Look at the Arabic sources. Also, I want to know what color is the womb of Allah.
Read it out loud, Arabic.
Yeah, read it for everyone.
Read it for everyone.
Be Lord, never be translated into English. Just leave it in Arabic. Leave it over there in the desert.
Apparently, they wouldn't have to do that, yeah.
I think the Crown Prince, I think he's doing that. He's going to get rid of
the load of
headaches.
Yeah.
And when he's
finished,
when he finished from his creation,
he created creation from his womb.
Allah created the creation when he stood. Sorry, Allah created the creation, and when he finished from his creation, the womb got up and said to Allah. Stop.
The womb spoke.
What do you want? Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir. The womb stood up and pulled at the lower garment of Allah. And Allah said, hush, stop it.
If you are telling this.
Allah, I don't know. I don't know what he's saying. Aisha reported that Allah has a womb.
Oh,
so who is?
Aisha is telling.
Who is?
Aisha is telling.
Who is?
Allah has a womb.
Where did he create the womb?
It says it in the hadith.
So where did he create the womb? No, where is the womb?
Where is it?
Is it in the paradise? Is it in the earth? Where is it? Where is the womb? Who is powerful to lower the garment of Allah?
What do you want about? He created it.
Listen.
Where is that womb?
Is powerful enough to go and grab down the lower garment of Allah.
English is mad. Read that.
My English is mad. Let's read it again. Let's read it again.
And read it out loud.
After Allah completed creating the creation, the womb stood up and pulled at the lower garment of Allah. And he said, stop that! Allah said, stop that! Because Allah is feeling the pain. Stop that!
I had a conversation with him.
And then boom, responded.
Boom, responded.
The womb is attached to the throne, according to Ibn Kathir. The womb is attached to the throne, who is powerful enough to bring the garment of Allah down. That's not very good. Aisha reported, Muhammad said, womb is suspended from the throne, suspended to the throne.
Is this the same one?
Yes. There is Allah created the creation, when he finished from his creation, the wrath that we got.
It's
the exact one, right?
Come on.
Yes or no?
Some who translate it, bits of translation, not a Christian preach many times, but some of the, when they translate it from Arabic to English, it's so embarrassing, they play semantics with the words, you know? So.
I don't care what they did with the translation, I've got the Arabic and English next to each other. Womb of Allah is speaking to Allah. Ibn Kathir.
Her point is that Allah has a womb.
Yeah, Allah has a womb. Allah's womb is bringing down the garment of Allah. Sahih Muslim 2555. Aisha reported, Allah's messenger.
What's the reference?
Sahih Muslim 2555. Aisha reported, Allah's messenger.
2555. Yeah. Oh, you're scary, bro. You're afraid of me here.
Do you need your mom? Do you need your mom? It looks like your mom needs to help you to grow up.
You're a child. Shut up.
Shut me up if that's possible. Aisha reported, Allah's messenger said, womb is suspended to the throne, and it says, he who unites me, Allah would unite him. I am reading Islamic sources. Why is this disrespect?
Can you speak to me?
I'm speaking. No, you are not being respectful. You are not being respectful to Allah.
Go read.
Tell me about the womb of Allah. Where is it?
The
womb Allah created, where it is?
Where is it?
Did he create it in paradise?
He created it in order to create humans. What's your point?
What kind?
He created the womb.
What is the womb?
Allah created humans. Listen, where the hell are humans?
I'm not understanding. Maybe because of my gender, or maybe Allah wants me to not understand.
The womb
Allah create,
yes,
is pulling down.
Oh, so you admit it? Allah
pulling down.
Womb.
Listen,
it's not Allah has a womb. All right, go on. Explain. I'm quiet. Come on, bro. Oh my God.
The womb. Okay. Sake of the argument, if Allah created, okay.
Speed it up, please.
Pulls down the lower garment of Allah. Where is this is taking place?
Where is that source?
Ah, okay.
Ibn Kathir.
So the woman pulling the garment of Allah. Where is that taking place?
Where's the source?
4722 Ibn Kathir.
Ibn Kathir.
Where is it taking place?
So you get it, yeah?
Even in the Sahih Bukhari. 7502. Where is it taking place? Whom is speaking to Allah?
I want to see the source.
I gave you the source.
What is the verse I'm talking about?
What is the verse I'm talking about?
Give me the verse.
Come to me when you bring your brain together. So, in Ibn Kathir, womb is powerful enough to pull down the garment of Allah. Okay? That's all I'm asking.
Come decide.
Let's talk. You can't even listen to my reference for me. What do you want? How many times I gave you Sahih Bukhari reference? How many times I gave you Ibn Kathir reference? What verse I'm talking about? Is it a verse? What verse I'm talking about?
She is talking about Surah 48.
No, Surah 47, 47. Verse 22. 22. So therefore, Ibn Kathir, Surah 47, verse 22. Yeah. I know your prophet couldn't read and write. Now we've got Oxford Uni, we've got Cambridge Uni.
You can read and study every language. That's a fake hadith.
What was the verse? He's asking the verse. Yeah.
How many times? Ibn Kathir.
He's asking as well.
Surah 47. Verse 22 for Ibn Kathir. The question is, if Muslims believe this is not the part of Allah, I am asking the question, where is the conversation is taking place that womb of Allah is taking down the lower garment of Allah? That's all I am asking. Read it out for me, sir. I can't hear. Speak up. Also, you are not talking to me. Okay, so he's not talking to me apparently, but let me go back to Ibn Kathir. So now we identified Allah has a ship, that's the body part of Allah. We identified Allah has a foot. We identified that Allah has a womb. We identified Allah is a curly hair, beardless, green dress, something. Okay. Now let's talk about what should we talk about? Other body parts of Allah. He's got lots of body parts. You don't know which one you should be talking.
So if that's the case. Yeah, what's that implication to Islam? What's, so if Allah has a womb, pull the garment of Allah. say, let's say in Jannah, what's that implications for Islam?
That's already a problem.
That's already a problem.
Yeah, so Muslim, so look, look, earlier Muslim said Allah doesn't have a body part.
Yeah.
Muslim says Allah has a body part. Muslim says Allah doesn't have a body part.
Okay.
Islamic tradition describes the body part of Allah. All I am trying to figure out how much messed Allah is. Once you know Allah is very much messed up, all we can do is run away from Allah and run to Lord Jesus Christ. Your Allah is bigger version of you, less body part version of you. Your Allah is not going to help you in any form or in any shape. Of course, we are also talking about Allah who prays 10 times for Allah, prays for self-control. Time to time, yes. But if you answer my question, we can move forward. Are you Muslim?
Take a little break.
Are you Muslim? So, I'm trying to figure out, does Allah have body parts or not?
Allah doesn't have body parts.
Allah doesn't have body parts.
Where do you get evidence from?
No, no. So, you believe Allah doesn't have body parts?
Where do you get all this from first?
Let me understand. Oh, well, I can give you Quran. I can give you Quran. I can give you Hadith, sure. I can give you tafsir.
Authentic hadith or hadith from your pocket?
Oh, I don't carry pocket hadith yet. You haven't
see,
made that yet.
It's metaphoric, you know? So, the stuff that's little, the
do
stuff
you believe,
metaphoric.
Do you believe? Do you believe Allah has body parts or not?
No, I want to say you're talking all day. Where's this you're getting this from? What's on the phone? I want to know where you're talking about. Because you're talking a lot, you know?
Sahih Bukhari.
Is this the hadith?
This is hadith, okay? So, background for Surah 86, not 86, 68, okay? So, Surah 68, verse 42. I know it is funny.
No, you're funny. What you're looking at maybe too, but I don't know what's on there, you know? You're talking
Sahih
6 hours, you're gonna get tired.
Sahih Bukhari. I heard the Prophet is saying, our Lord, Allah, will lay bare his shit. So you said Allah doesn't have a body part. If Allah doesn't have body parts, how he is gonna reveal his shin?
You know, this sister has literal meaning and is metaphoric meaning.
Okay, what is
did
it?
You study, did you study?
Give me both. Give me both. Both. Both meaning. Give me the both meaning.
I don't know because I haven't studied this. I don't know this.
You haven't studied, but you know it has a full meaning. You haven't studied, but you know it has two meanings.
Are you talking to me or are you talking to me?
I'm just trying to make sense what you are saying.
You're asking me a question.
I'm trying to make sense what you are saying.
Because you're here to argue and spread all this. You know,
what is the shin Allah is going to... What is the shin Allah is going to reveal so that people can recognize him? People can recognize him on the day of judgment.
That's how I know you. You ask the question, you listen to the answer, you know?
Give me the answer.
I'll tell you what I know from my knowledge. When in the hadith and the Quran there's literal meaning and there's metaphoric meaning. Just as in the Bible there's literal meaning and there's metaphoric meaning.
Okay, is this metaphorical?
You know this too.
Of course. Is this metaphorical?
Of course.
If it is metaphorical,
okay, let me
respond to that. If it is metaphorical,
you are going
to recognize him from his shit?
Are you letting me speak or I walk?
No, I
speak.
This is conversation back and forth.
This is one side conversation.
If it is metaphorical, what is it says? He is going to uncover it.
Okay, I'll say one thing.
Uncover the shit.
I'll say this one thing. And then I'll leave you. You'll leave you to it.
If you're not going to listen to my response, just walk away now.
You're speaking all time though.
It can't be metaphorical.
No,
reason for that
you know,
is because
you know
Allah because
you know?
Allah says because it says
how
it's gonna
know?
Be uncovered. It is hidden under
how
something.
You know
Allah is
it
gonna
is
uncover
literally
it.
Uncovered. Literally.
Uncovered.
Literally.
If it is metaphorical, such a word wouldn't be used. If it is metaphorical, it wouldn't say that's the way people are going to recognize Allah on the day of judgment. What is the way? When Allah uncovers his
shin.
Remember, Allah is wearing green robe.
Yeah.
Under the green robe, Allah has a shin. Is that shin? Shave, unshave. What kind of cream Allah used to shave his shin if it is shaved? That's all I'm curious about.